Hello guys, want to review these few amps I got. These are my D-Class amps by MidimonO. I won these on an auction and got a great price for them and have been working on them a little bit, fixing them up, cleaning them up, but also using them for some magnapans, which are another review. So if you see that, as always, please like and share my video, and you know, subscribe if you want to see more. I'm gonna do more and more of these, but these are MidimonO, and they are two separate amps here. Each one, this one is a 300 watt version, and the normal disclosure that I give on all my videos is do not take off the cover off of these if you do not know what you're doing. You may want to just take a couple days and let it decharge. These capacitors here do carry a voltage big enough to kill you. These have been sitting around for about a week, so the capacitors are certainly used up. So there, we've got, of course, the transformer here, and then we've got the power supply capacitors here and here, and they're both very nice. I mean, the people who did this is a MidimonO audio, but this Triple M modified them and have put in these high quality audio capacitors. They also replace these with some high quality ends up here, I know, and they did a few other things. One of the problems I've had with these is that when I got them, the only way to turn them on is through a remote on off 12 volt trigger here, which is nice, but this switch up here doesn't work. So I took them apart and looked at them, and there's a little jumper in here, and I found that if you switch that jumper, all of a sudden they start turning on, even without the 12 volt. So they work a little differently just by that. But because I don't have a switch then, because the switch is deactivated, I've been working on replacing these by putting a bridge here and here, and then tying this onto a different one of these plugs here. So moving this wire over here and putting a jumper over there. I'm gonna be making a video showing how I did it, but I wanted to review these. This one's, as I said, 300 watts. It's rated for 4 ohms. I'm pretty sure it will go down to 2 ohms. I do use it for powering my magnapans, and I enjoy them very much for that. They have a lot of power. So when I'm not using my tube amps, which is rare, and I want a little bit more power, these guys can handle it. On the back, they have these two high quality speaker wire posts that I said the company replaced, and these, this high quality RCA down here. It also has a balanced input for an XLR connection. And that really works. That's one of my favorite parts about this. I really like the balanced audio. It just, I do have quite a few problems with ground back, you know, feedback loops and things like that. So having that can definitely help reduce that noise. And especially on the mono, these types of devices, the mono blocks, because this is one channel, we have two of these. I tend to, well, we're losing the light. Let's fix that. I tend to want to use the XLRs because I use the, I leave these closer to the speakers generally. Which means the power wire can get a little longer and you have more problems with those ground loops. So, you know, the other thing I do when I'm in here is I just look around, make sure all of the capacitors are in good quality, that there's no electrolytics. If you do see electrolytics, it will show usually up on top. These are a little puffy, but I don't think there's any problems with them. They are both very nice. It looks like this one is a 10,000 UF plus or minus 20% capacitor for those that are interested. And there's two of them in there. They're the foil, so they're probably aluminum electrolytic capacitors. And then we got the plug back here. So I'll be re-enabling this switch here so that I can use it. And then I'll be able to control whether or not I want to use the 12-volt trigger with this little jumper in here and be able to disable it that way. Making these a little better. And my little tip for today is that when you're doing this work and you take off all the screws and stuff, you'll notice you blemish the surface of the screws somewhat so that they start to show metal. And if you do that, I recommend you get one of these felt-tip black pen markers. This one has a wide tip and a very thin tip, which is nice for these screws because you can put it in there and make that look black. And every little dot that you start to hide makes a clean image. Now moving over to the 200-watt version. And I'll post these stats for people who want to see them and the model numbers of these if I can still find them. They are modified, so check the description for that. But this is the 300-watt one. I'll try to hold this still while I'm still shaking a little bit. And pretty much the same design, just a little smaller transformer, it looks like. Probably less, it's smaller gauged wire you see here. So that is probably why it's a little lower. The transformer has a lower gauge wire probably in it, and therefore is why this doesn't make 300 watts, because these boards look almost identical to each other. Otherwise, they're very close to each other, and they're not identical, but they're very close. I'm actually surprised by how few components are in this and how good it sounds. I've always heard a lot of bad things about the amps, and to be honest with you, this sounds as crystal clear as the mono. As the other solid states I've used, the ABs and even some of the As. So maybe my ears are not as good as some of your guys. I definitely notice a different sound coming from D amps, but I don't know if I could pick them out of a lineup. So a double blind study on two different amps, I don't know if I could tell if this between this and an AB. But maybe some of you guys have ears better than I. Anyways, I do recommend these MIDI mod amps. I think they sell new. The 300 watt one I've seen for about 500 to 600. Some of them sell two. There's a bunch of different models I have seen of these amplifier models, and you can build these yourself generally. They do sell these components separately. So you can even just put all the parts together if you want. But I didn't do that. I bought these from a man who warrantied them. And they're a few years old. But the 300 does still retain the XLR, which is very valuable in my opinion. And I really like it. I think that's everything. I think that's what I wanted to show you guys. I appreciate you guys checking out my channel again. I love making these videos for you. If you keep watching, I'll keep posting them. So I got some conversions over. I'm going to be converting these, like this one, back so that I can use the switch. And when I do that, then we will be... good to go on them, I think, because they're using the trigger has been a little bit difficult, especially in so many devices, four different devices. And also my other argument is that these are D-class amps, so they are very efficient. And if they're left on, you know, it's more power than I would like. to use, but it's not going to break the bank. And so, you know, the trigger is a little less valuable than, say, a Class A amp or something. Though I've never seen a trigger on a Class A amp. Anyways, these are my two MIDI mods, and I hope you guys enjoyed them. Gave you some speaker porn and stuff. Got to clean up this dust in here. Clean up the whole thing, get my vacuum cleaner in there, and make it look like brand new. Thank you.